speaking with Malcolm Norris this morning from Sunstone Metals. Malcolm, morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Yeah, good to speak, Malcolm. Big update from you yesterday here. This, in your words, outstanding 269-metre-long intersection, just over a gram a tonne at Limon. Just tell us a bit more about this.
Yeah, it truly is an outstanding intersection. So 269 metres at just over a gram. There's some high-grade zones within that. And, you know, we've got peak values over a metre of 2 ounces of gold and 900 grams of silver. I mean, these are phenomenal numbers. But when you stand back from all that excitement and have a look at it, we think this is delivering to us a true width of this central chute of about 125 metres, which fundamentally doubles the expectations that we had from the earlier drilling on just how big this is. So a great result, just fantastic result.
You mentioned the central chute. That's one of three zones of mineralization you've got here, is it?
That's right. So the central chute. So it's now becoming pretty well defined. So this hole that we released yesterday, hole 40, was drilled at right angles to many of the other holes. And that also adds to its significance. So a great intersection at right angles. And then we've got the support of all those other previous holes that we've announced. So that's defining a central chute. And as I said, true width, we think is about 125 metres. The sort of lateral extent along strike, we think is at least 100 metres. And we're seeing a vertical extent of this this system of comfortably 300 metres. And we haven't really tested below that, but we assume it will keep going. So, you know, that gives you some idea of dimensions of the central chute. Then we have a domain that's about 800 metres by 300 metres that we have drilled some holes into. Pretty well all of them are mineralised. So that's the bigger area that we've got to do some more drilling on to try to define other chutes, because we're getting a hint of that in hole 29, which is another chute nearby. And then we stand back and have another look at the broader Limon area, which is 1.7 kilometres by 700 metres. And in a figure in this announcement and all of our other announcements, we show that broader Limon area, which has several areas of gold in soil anomaly and some evidence of epithermal mineralization with surface sampling and things. So I think investors are best placed to look at it from this point of view. Central chute becoming well-defined, outer ring to that central chute mineralized from all our drilling. So we'll do more drilling there and build that up. And then this broader picture where we've got a number of these epithermal systems. So what that means is that Limon is delivering a fantastic outcome, could be a development in its own right, not just the starter pit opportunity that we'd talked about. So lots of reasons to be optimistic on this one.
And how's work, Malcolm, on an exploration target for Limon?
Yep. So that's the logical next step for us with Limon. And we expect to put something out in November. So an exploration target is a precursor to mineral resources, and you can put out an exploration target with qualifications, a range of tons, a range of grade, and that allows you to sort of build the concept of what you're chasing in a mineral resource estimate that will come later. So we'll do that work in November for an exploration target, and these results absolutely help us with geometry, help us with optimism. So yeah, great result yesterday. And we've got a few more assays coming during November as well. So once they're out, we'll be in a position to release that exploration target.
Yeah, good to speak, Malcolm. Thanks for your time.
Thanks very much, Andrew. Pleasure. Thank you. Bye.